five questions. Five questions. Do you think there is something that you can do over the next 2 to 3 weeks that would make your spiritual life, your personal life, your family life, your business life, your academic life worse? Hope you get the question. Question number two. Do you think there is something that you can do to make your life, all that I have enumerated and others, to make your life any better? Three. Do you think that the choice is yours? Number four. Do you think that every choice has an end result? Number five. Do you think making the right choice is your responsibility? I have, in a sense, asked you, in asking these questions, if you answered them, you would have said, regardless of how good or how bad my past has been, regardless of how good or bad my present is, there is something specifically that I can do now that will make my future either good or better or worse.
Amen.
The choice,
amen,
is yours.
Amen. Amen.
I repeat,
amen,
the choice,
amen,
is yours. And just in case you missed it,
amen,
I want to repeat this. Regardless of how bad or good your past has been, some of us have had good past. Some of us have had bad. Some of us have had mixed. Amen. Regardless of how good or bad your present condition is, hallelujah, there is something you can do, something that you can specifically do now.
Amen.
That would either make your future better or worse. And my point is, the choice is,
amen,
yours.
Amen. 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 Amen.
It's yours.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You see, my dear friend, everything is choice.
Amen.
Say that. Say everything,
everything is
choice.
Is mine.
The choice is mine.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Corporal.
Amen.
Nice to have you downstairs here with us this morning.
Amen.
The choice is yours. And if we personalize it, we would be saying, the choice is
mine.
Mine.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
It is mine. Glory be to God.
Amen.
You see, the important man,
amen,
hallelujah,
amen,
who we read about, hallelujah, had to make a choice whether to take up his bed and walk,
amen,
and be made whole, or whether not to take up his bed and be whole.
Amen.
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 The choice is up to you.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I've said to you repeatedly that you are where you are. In many ways, because of a series of choices you have made.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen.
You are where you are.
Amen.
And you are what you are.
Amen.
Because of a series of choices that you have made in your past. Hallelujah to the Lamb. Amen. Some of you might be in a comfortable position because you have made some excellent choices. And there are those that are struggling because you have made some poor choices. Hallelujah to the Lamb. But my contention, my presentation to you this morning is simply this, hallelujah, that you can change. Amen. Your situation can change. You can change where you are. You can change who you are. Hallelujah. By simply deciding, amen, to make the right choice. Amen. Not only today, but tomorrow and every single day of your life. Somebody say amen. If you are with me, say hallelujah. I say hallelujah to the Lamb. Amen. You see, friend, responsibility. Somebody say responsibility. Responsibility carries with it a lot of weight in this life.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And the responsibility is yours to make the right choice.
Amen. Amen.
It is not anybody's. Anybody else's responsibility.
No.
It is yours.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I say hallelujah.
Amen.
I have noticed.
No.
I have noticed, dear friends. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When the economy is great, when there is a lot of well sufficient. Because too much of money chasing too few goods could lead to inflation. So you have to kind of balance it, right?
Amen.
Amen. But when the economy is great, unfortunately, there are many persons that are still broke. Why? Did you observe that as well? You don't have to be an economist to know that. If you have lived through the many oil booms that we have had, with so much of petrodollars, well, continue yourself, Pastor. Hallelujah. Amen. But I have also noticed, amen, that at times when the economy is bad, there's still a lot of rich people.
Yes, true.
And a lot of people getting rich.
Amen, true. Amen.
Buying up a lot of material things.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Yes. What am I saying? I am saying, my dear friend, it is my calculated opinion that people, amen, in either situation made a choice, hallelujah, either to improve on the standard and quality of living, or whether to choose, amen, to remain at a base condition, a situation, and to make a false and perhaps even deceitful conclusion. Well, I was born to be like that. The truth is, you were not born, amen, to be a loser. You were born to be a winner. You were born, hallelujah, to be victorious. You were born, hallelujah, with greatness on the inside of you. You were endowed with those seeds, hallelujah, to the Lamb, amen. But it is not automatic, my dear friend. You must have a plan, and the plan starts with a choice. Hallelujah. I say hallelujah.
Amen.
Now, that's one point. So, what you all tell me is, okay. Point number two. It is not about what is going on out there. There's a lot of things going on out there. And for your information, much of what is going on there, 90, maybe 99%, but let me take it conservatively, 90%, of what is happening out there, you cannot change.
Amen.
You cannot change the pandemic.
Amen. True. Amen.
You cannot change the politics, amen, in America.
No.
You cannot change, amen, no, the march that China is making, no, in the world.
Amen. True.
Hallelujah.
True.
I'm saying, amen, there much of what is happening out there, you cannot change. But may I remind you, it is not about what is going on out there. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. And while I'm saying that, I'm also saying, while, amen, there is nothing that you can do about much that is going on the outside, there is something that you can do about
you.
You don't have the responsibility of the world. You're not responsible for the economy of Trinidad and Tobago, but you are responsible about your own situation.
Amen.
I say amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I say hallelujah to the Lord.
Amen.
You see, there is something that you can do about you. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let me tell you by comparison again.
Amen.
Amen. It is not what happens out there that makes the difference in your life. It is what happens between your two ears.
Amen. Amen.
Measure it.
Yes, sir. Amen.
It's what happens here.
Amen.
That will make the difference.
Amen.
Hallelujah to the Lamb. I say hallelujah, amen, to the Lamb. Amen.
Amen.
Well, one time, Jesus' disciples asked him a question. Who did sin?
Amen.
Did this man or his parents? Who sinned that he is in this condition? That he is a blind man? Hallelujah to the Lamb. And you know what Jesus said? No, amen. It is not his parents. I'm leaving out a part of the answer. Read it for yourself. But I'll tell you, half of the answer was that Jesus said, amen, his parents had nothing to do with this.
Amen. Amen.
All right.
Amen.
So what are you going to say there? This is what I'm going to say.
Amen.
It is not who your parents are or who they might have been.
Yes, sir. Amen. Amen.
Well, if I was born in the right family,
amen,
if I was born in the West,
Remember.
I was born in the West. Well, not quite West, but Porter Street. General Hospital. If I was the son of a one percenter, you know how far I would have been.
Amen. Yes, sir.
Amen.
True.
I guarantee you, friend, hallelujah, that there are many, hallelujah, maybe multiplied hundreds of thousands who have not had that privilege, amen, whose lives are more rewarding and fulfilling and perhaps even more prosperous than those who have had that good fortune. Are you hearing what I'm saying? I'm saying it is not who your parents are or what they may have been. I know that there are many of you who have what can be referred to as hard luck stories. You were not born to the right people. Amen. The color of the skin, hallelujah, texture of hair, and other things, hallelujah, amen, did not work for you. Amen. There are many with stories like that. But hear me, friend, that should not work against you. Amen. You have no control over that. What happens outside there, it is not, amen, and within your control. But I tell you, what is within your control is what happens between here, what happens here, and you have a responsibility. I have a responsibility, amen, to make good use of that. Somebody say amen. Hallelujah. It is not what your parents are doing. It is not what they have been. Hallelujah. I say hallelujah. I'm sure if I did some kind of investigation here this morning, there are those who might be able to take this mic for me and give your hard stories. Hallelujah. That you probably know the days. Hallelujah. In your young life when you lived here and there and the other. Amen. Because, amen, of a worthless father. Amen. You probably can talk a lot. Amen. If it wasn't, amen, for him, you know what I would have been today. Amen. I want to say one word. But only him.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
I don't know, except perhaps of one or two in this congregation here, and those upstairs there who have inherited anything.
Amen.
You've had to work hard for every single thing that you've had in your
Amen.
Life.
Amen.
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 Hallelujah.
Amen.
I say hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. You had no rich aunt or parent, hallelujah, that left a lump sum for you, amen, on the demise. Nobody left a plot of land so you could put up a little jura, hallelujah. No, sorry, you've had to fight every inch of the way, and I salute you this morning, hallelujah, because, my dear friend, it is not what happens outside, hallelujah, it is what happens on the inside. Come on, amen. I say amen. It is what you do. As a pastor, I encounter quite frequently many persons, hallelujah, who enjoy a pity party. Who enjoy a pity party. They have what I call the PMO disease. Do you know what the PMO disease is? I'll tell you. It is poor me one. And by the way, the problem with picky parties is this. Very few persons turn up. And those who come, they bring no presents. I'm looking for support up there. I'm looking for support up there. Hallelujah. I say hallelujah.
Amen.
It's not what happens to you. It's not what happens on the outside. What happens on the inside. Third and final point is this. It is not what happens to you. It is how you handle it. What happens to you. That is what's going to make the difference. How you handle it. Hallelujah. I'll tell you that story a little bit about a man named John Fox. Hallelujah. But it is how you handle it. I must tell you, hallelujah, that at chapter 3, I believe that Peter and John went up to the gate, to the temple, hallelujah, and arrived at the gate, beautiful, where they were confronted with a man who was born lame.
Yes, sir. Amen.
And I observed, hallelujah, while there was a lot of commerce that was taking place all around him, and a lot of religion all around him, hallelujah, amen, he was still in his lame condition.
Amen.
But if credit must be given to this man, it must be for this. He was there, amen, daily. Hallelujah. However, he prepared himself to get there. Hallelujah. He was there daily.
Amen.
It could have been easy, amen, to stay at home, amen, and wait on government check to come. Hallelujah. It could have been easy, amen, to stay at home and depend on handout from somebody. But guess what? That man went to work, albeit his work was at the mercy of people begging.
Yes, sir. Amen.
But on a daily basis, hallelujah, he would get dressed. However, whether he bathed, whether he changed his clothes, hallelujah, I do not know. But on it, amen, or whether he had to ask people, amen, to help him to do that, maybe, hallelujah, he paid a vehicle, amen. A stipend once a week.
Amen.
Amen. You take me every day.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
But my dear brother, he had a mind. He had a purpose.
Amen.
That he, amen,
amen,
he was not suffering from PMO. Hallelujah. He was going to get there. Hallelujah to the Lamb.
Amen.
Amen. You see, it is not what happens to you. It is how you handle what has happened to you. That is what is going to make the difference. How you handle it. Amen. Many of you have had, hallelujah, many of you have had unfortunate experiences in your lifetime, in your childhood, maybe in your youthful days. Hallelujah. Maybe you suffered, hallelujah, from a lack of various things. Hallelujah. The protection of an adult. Hallelujah. One who should have protected you was the one who abused you. Hallelujah. When you thought that marriage, amen, would have been the answer. It failed miserably. Hear me, my dear friend. Hallelujah. You have your stories. Hallelujah. And I'm saying, hallelujah, you can feel sorry for yourself. Hallelujah. Amen. Or you can decide to do something about it. You can decide, hallelujah, amen, that this is not the end of my life, or that experience, or those experiences did not end my life, because the truth is simply this: my yesterday ended last night. Hallelujah. This is a new day. This is the day the Lord has made. I will rejoice in it. I will be glad. Somebody talk to me today. Hallelujah. Or maybe you have tried and failed and tried and failed. Hallelujah. And you probably are thinking of yourself as a failure. But hear me, friend, failure is not a person. Failure is an event. Get up, shake yourself off. Hallelujah. And try again. Hallelujah be the Lamb. I say hallelujah be the Lamb. The man that, amen, discovered light and electricity, tried over 1,000 times. Amen. And somebody asked him the question, well, you failed 1,000 times. He said, oh no, I learned 1,000 ways how it will not work. Somebody talk to me today. It's not what happens to you, it's how you handle what has happened to you.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Thank you. Amen. I say amen. So let me tell you a little bit about John Fock. John Fock was recognized as one of the top 10 young Americans by the U.S. Junior Chamber of Commerce. Big deal. Well, I tell you, to make it top 100 in a tiny island like this. Some of us have never done that. In the vast continent of the U.S. of A. This guy made it in the top 10. Top 10. By the age of 90, and I kind of did that myself, but by the age of 90, he was speaking before audiences made up of admirals and generals of the U.S. Armed Forces. He spoke at the age of 19 before CEOs of Fortune 500 companies. Hallelujah. At the age of 19, he was speaking with confidence and clarity and conviction and power. Hallelujah. Amen. I'm going to say something that's going to shock you now. At the age of 19, he could drive a car. He could scramble eggs. He could ski. He could paint portraits. Big deal.
Amen. You see. Amen. Amen.
Big deal, you say.
Amen.
What made the difference?
Amen.
Between John Fock and other teenagers, what made him different that he could have done these things?
Amen.
Drive a car, scramble eggs, ski. Paint a portrait. You see, John Fock was born without arms. I repeat it for my obsessed people. John Fogg was born without arms. Can you picture that? This guy was born without arms. All he has legs. He goes to Hilton. He climbs up. He's about to throw himself down because he's frustrated. He can do nothing. Well, actually, he wasn't born without arms. This was a normal guy. Sorry. Came across a bad patch. Nothing was, his marriage was broke. His children were against him. He lost his job. Put him out of his house. He thought life wasn't worth living. Only last night he went up, climbed up one of those iron areas and was about to throw himself down the precipice. And as he looked down, he saw people out in the courtyard and they're dancing. But who caught his eye was one guy without arms.
Amen. True. Amen. Amen. Yes, sir. Amen. True.
He looked again.
Yes, sir.
And he said, never.
Yes, sir.
How the man so happy?
True. Amen.
Sam was investigated. He went down. He said, you know, guy, let me tell you something. Today, you saved my life. He said, how so? He said, well, I was up there. Frustrated. Depressed. I was about to throw myself down. Commit suicide. And when I looked down, I saw you. A man with no arm. I was happy and dancing.
Amen.
Amen. I look around and say, happy and dancing.
Amen.
He said, boy, my back's scratching me.
Amen.
Thank you.
Amen.
Look, I'm not, poking for that. Be unfortunate, eh?
Amen.
Just wanted to wake you up, some of you fellas.
Yes,
hallelujah.
Amen. Yes, sir.
John Fogg was born without arms.
Amen. Yes.
Can you picture that?
Amen.
And at the age of 19, having all that accomplishment, which some of us born normal,
yes, sir.
Have only had in our dreams. Think about what I'm saying.
Amen. True.
Hallelujah.
True.
Listen to the testimony of John Fogg. He would say, if I had the longest and strongest arms ever put on a human being, they'd still be only so high I could reach.
Amen. Amen.
Think about that. There is only so much weight that I could lift.
Amen.
Think about it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He said, I don't care how long and tall and strong and big your arms might be, they have a limit.
Amen. Amen.
He continued, but I have faced more situations every day of my life where I have had to use my creative imagination than the average person does in a month. There is no limit to what we can do internally. Are you understanding what I'm saying, friend? Hallelujah. He had to find ways, amen, of how to do things that normal people do. Hallelujah. And you know how he did it? He did it by using what was between these two heirs. Are you understanding? It is how you respond to it. Hallelujah to the Lamb. I say hallelujah to the Lamb. You see, folks, through these series of messages that I have presented to you over the past 3 months. Today's the last, I'm telling you, turn in the corner. My goal was to show you you were designed for accomplishment. You were engineered for success. Hallelujah. You were endowed with the seeds of greatness. You were born to win. But to win, you have to have a plan. You plan for it. You prepare for it. And only then can you expect. Amen. I repeat it. You plan for it. You prepare for it. And you expect. So you have been saying for the past 3 months, hallelujah, that you were born to win. And if I have a plan, hallelujah, I am going to win. But I ask the question, what really is winning? What is winning? What it means to win? The truth is, the reality is, from observance and experience, everybody wants to be happy. I have not met in my brief sojourn on this earth as yet. I have not yet met as yet in my brief sojourn on this earth someone who ever said to me, I want to be miserable. If you have, I don't want to read that piece. That was not normal. That person belonged to the man who called me up and said that. Everybody wants to be happy. Everybody wants to be healthy. Who wants to be sick? Everybody wants to be reasonably prosperous. Even though I know some, not from here, all of them, who might want to be exceptionally prosperous. But it's not even a reason. When you get there, you'll see further. Hallelujah. Everybody wants to be secure. Everybody wants to have friends. Everybody wants to have peace of mind. Everybody wants a good family and good family relationships. Hallelujah. Amen. Everybody wants to have a good future. Am I right?
Yes.
Am I right? Of shares, am I right? Hallelujah. I am right. Hallelujah. Isn't that what salvation is about? It starts with salvation.
Amen.
Because salvation is all inclusive. The primary goal, the primary thing about salvation, hallelujah, is to save us from hell, hellfire, which is in the future. Amen. And there is hope for the future. But included in salvation, which is all inclusive. Hallelujah. Amen. Included in salvation is healing, is peace of mind, is included prosperity. Hallelujah. Included in salvation. Read the book again. Read it good. Read it. Hallelujah. Amen. It includes good and happy relations. Amen. With one another, with our families, with our kinfolk, with our brethren. Hallelujah. I say hallelujah. Talk to me this morning, church. Amen. But if it is to be, it is up to me. If it is to be, it is up to you. The choice remains yours. And the responsibility for that choice is still yours. Somebody say
amen. Amen.
If in eternity any one of us find ourselves in the other place with the other guy, it would not have been because of Jesus.
Amen.
I was going to say, it would not have been because of me, but I would have been thinking too highly about myself. I did absolutely nothing. But he did everything to ensure, hallelujah, that you don't go there. Hallelujah. He condescended to men of low estate. He came out of the bosom of the Father. Hallelujah. Glory. He became a man. Amen. The Creator became part of the creation. Hallelujah. And then in the fullness of time, gave himself up to be crucified, dead, and buried. Hallelujah. Why? So that we might be saved. Hallelujah. For the choice is yours. The choice is yours. Amen. If we ever go to hell, it's because we chose to go. Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen.
If our prayer lives are nothing, it is because we chose for it to be nothing.
Amen. Amen. Yes, sir.
But Pastor,
amen,
you don't know how taxing prayer is.
Yes,
trust me, I do.
Amen.
I am up nearly every morning, 3 o'clock.
Amen.
I know how taxing prayer can be.
Amen.
It is hard work.
Amen.
You have to beat back forces. You have to beat back thoughts. You have to beat back much negativity. You have to beat back, hallelujah, responsibilities as well. Because while I'm wasting time here, I could have put up lentil. Whatever you do with lentil. Or I could have kicked out the meat and start to grind up pise masala. So I could, when they come home later, are you hearing what I'm saying? Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. And amen. You have to deal with all those competing things. Hallelujah. Other things that are vying for your attention. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. But the choice, amen, is mine. Whether I want to sacrifice those things. Hallelujah. Or to have at least a reasonable Amen. Good prayer life. Hallelujah. Well, at least I say the Our Father prayers. Hallelujah. Are you hearing what I'm saying tonight today? Hallelujah. Well, at least I ask God for guidance and leading and deliverance. Hallelujah. Trust me, my dear friend. Hallelujah. After 2-3 weeks or maybe 2 or 3 months, you will be praying for other things. Your prayer life will grow. You will grow. Amen. Spiritually. Amen. But the choice is.
Amen. Good. Good. Amen. 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 Amen.
The choice is.
Amen. Good. Amen. Good. Amen. 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 So.
Hours and hours this week that I could have dedicated on the way.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
The choice is.
Amen.
Thank you.
Amen. Go. Go.
Wonders of above.
Amen. Amen.
From us, force.
Amen.
Forces. Hallelujah.
Go. Amen.
The energies that are extended. Hallelujah. I mean, after this.
Amen.
All I could do is just go and drink a cup of dal. Amen. At 2:30, there's another appointment. Hallelujah. No telling what time that will finish. Your day might end when you leave here. Hallelujah. But I have to go on and on and on. Amen. Hallelujah. But the choice is mine.
Yes, sir. Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I say hallelujah.
Yes, sir. Amen.
Hallelujah to God. So, dear friend,
excuse me.
Hallelujah. You can choose to be healthy. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's not my responsibility. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
If, hallelujah. You can choose to have peace of mind. Hallelujah. Amen. By accepting the Lord. You can choose the friends. Hallelujah. That you have. You can choose to be secure. Hallelujah to the Lamb. I'm saying, my friend, glory be to God. Hallelujah. That your future, amen, from where you are looking out, it might look bleak. It might look uncertain. Hallelujah to the Lamb. But I'm saying, take it one bite at a time. Take it one day at a time. Take it, hallelujah, every day. This is what I do. Hallelujah. This is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice in it. I will be glad in it. Day mine. God never called us to take quantum leaps, but he did call us to take steps. Hallelujah. Take it one step at a time. One at a time. Amen. Before long, you would have been, hallelujah, much further, hallelujah, than if you didn't start off at at all. Amen. In trying to make quantum leaps. Amen. You can damage yourself. You can injure yourself. You can become discouraged. Hallelujah. Because all that run. Hallelujah. And amen. And when you took off, you went higher than you went further. Hallelujah to the Lamb. And you might say, amen. All that effort. And this is only where I have reached. And saying, my friend, do not waste your effort. Do not waste your energies. Amen. Channel them in the right direction. Amen. What is more important? Time or energy? Is it better to use your time wisely or your energies wisely? I'll go for the energy.
Amen.
Because if I channel my energy in the right direction, in time, I can have what God says. I can have. I can do what God say. I can do. Hallelujah. I can be who God say that I can be. Hallelujah to the Lamb. I say hallelujah because, amen, I am using, hallelujah, what God has endowed me with. Hallelujah. Let's stand up. How many of you received something here this morning?
Amen.
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 The choice,
yes, sir. Amen.
Is ours.
True.
Amen.
Amen.
It is not what is going on out there.
Amen. True. Amen.
It is not what happens out there that makes the difference.
Amen.
It is what goes on between,
yes,
here and here.
Hallelujah. Amen.
It is not what happens to you, it is how you handle what happens to you, or what has happened to you. Well, I want us to pause at this point. Hallelujah. And I want you to take some time. Take some time. Consider what I've said this morning and over the past 3 months. If you've had the benefit of the past 3 months, and you should have had because I've taken my time, Sunday after Sunday, to share. Hallelujah. I say hallelujah. But even if you missed something, you didn't miss this morning. Make up your mind. Make up your mind. I will choose this day who I will serve. Amen. Like Joshua said, choose you this day who you will serve. Glory. I say glory. Hallelujah. Spirit of the living God. Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit. Let it start with you. And then with the help of the Holy Spirit by inviting him in to your life. I want you to make that decision. Make that decision. You can change where you are. And you can change who you are. Making the decision. By making the right choice. Hallelujah. Spirit of the living God. Hallelujah. So I want to ask everybody. Some of you already are doing it. Hallelujah. I want to ask you this to join me. Amen. Take a moment. Take a time. Take some time. Hallelujah. Make that decision. Make up your mind. Make up your mind. Make up your mind. Make up your mind. Hallelujah. 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 Amen. I make up my mind this morning. I make up my mind this morning. Hallelujah. And I've called on you people to make up their minds in the next 2 or 3 weeks, hallelujah, to do something that would make their lives better, that will make their spiritual lives better, their personal lives better, their family lives better, their business lives better, their academic lives better, their relational issues better. Hallelujah to the Lamb. Amen. Oh God, hallelujah, that they will choose to do something today. Hallelujah. Amen. That we will realize, hallelujah, that the choice is ours. Amen. That we will realize, hallelujah, that every choice has an end result. That we will realize that making the right choice is our responsibility. And that regardless of how good or bad our past has been, and regardless of how good or bad our present is, that there is something that we can do, that we can specifically do now. Hallelujah, that will make our future either better or worse. Hallelujah, and we will make the choice, hallelujah, to make it better. With the help of the Holy Spirit. With the help of the Holy Spirit. God is in this house this morning. Hallelujah, praise the Lord. And you may be seated just for a minute or so, just to receive the announcement. We're going to thank our bishop for ministering the word of the Lord unto us this morning. You know, surely God has spoken in this house this morning. Bishop, we give you, we say thank you very much. Just to give you the announcements, remember that this morning at 11 a.m. we have our SOS, or Sunday School on social media, at 11 a.m. and that's on our AWC page, that's online. On Tuesday, we have our empowerment service at 6 p.m. and that again is online. On Wednesday, we have a day of prayer and fast, and we pray and fast during the day, and we gather in church at 6 p.m. where we pray together as a body. Our directions will be sent to us through Sister Maureen. So on Wednesday, we are in church physically. On Saturday morning, we have our lamp and light at 8:30 a.m. That's online. And next Sunday, our morning worship service at 7:25 right here in church. Remember, an upcoming activity, we will be having evangelistic work, evangelistic efforts and activities, and it will start in the month of March, not next Thursday, but from afterward. And we are encouraging you this morning, if you are interested in being part of the evangelistic work and the activities that we are going to have as a church, please give your name to Reverend Camille before you leave. So that is going to be upcoming. So we do have a full week, both online and in church. We want to ask you to be part of our presentation and be part of our services, and be blessed in what we do. Let's all stand this morning as we get ready to dismiss. Almighty God, we give you all praise and all glory, O God. Surely, O God, you're a good God. Father, we thank you, O God, because no greater love, but no man than this, that a man would lay down his life for his friends, O God. Father, we thank you, O God, for the way that you think about us, O God. Thank you for the things that you have laid down for us, O God, even before the foundation of this world, O God. You had already planned for us. I pray today that we would make that choice, O God. And we'll continue making good and godly choices, O God, that would bring us into the fulfillment of your will over our lives, O God. Father, I pray that the fear of God will guide our talks, O God. And that, Lord God, we will walk in the steps that you have called us to walk in, O God. We will manifest the glory of God, that others may see it, O God. And the praise will go unto you, O God. Father, we thank you for the opportunity to have been here in your house this morning, God. Thank you for everything said and done. We ask that even as we go our separate ways, now that you will go with us and you will go before us, O God. Prepare the way that we may reach you safely, O God. Give us a good day, a good week. Strengthen us, O God. Keep us and bring us back at the next appointed time. In the mighty name of the living Christ, with thanksgiving. Amen. Amen. So we are dismissed. Let us greet the brethren. The Lord bless you richly.